Dear students, so in this session we will discuss problem on the preparation of the trading account, profit and loss account and balance sheet with respect to the sole trader. So you know that in the previous session we had discussed about the preparation of the same with respect to the sole trader. So you'll be able to understand how we will prepare the trading P&L and balance sheet after certain taking adjustments with respect to the sole trader. So first we will analyze the problem, then we will go to the solution. So from the following trial balance of Mr. Kumar, we have to prepare the trading profit and loss account as well as balance sheet for the year ending 31st December 2019. And the value of the closing stock was given is ₹2,50,000. So you know that the closing stock usually considered as adjustment. So adjustment is having two effects. So once it should be written in the trading account in the credit side, and next time it is coming in balance sheet asset side. Fine. So now we will consider the trial balance. So debit balance always it is a part of the assets or maybe expenses. So stock they given on 1/1/2019. So it is the opening stock. So usually coming in the trading account debit side. Purchases debit side of trading account. Carriage inward. It is also part of the trading account. Wages. Trading account, salaries, profit and loss account, debit side, repairs, rent and taxes. So both are expenses appearing in the debit side of trading account. Cash in hand and land is considered as assets. Drawings usually we have to deduct from the capital from the liability side. So drawings is nothing but the amount taken for maybe the personal use, personal purpose. And next, bank deposit we may consider as short term deposit or long term deposit. Usually it is coming in the balance sheet. Next, on the credit side, the items are appearing in the liabilities or may be considered as incomes. So sundry creditors as considered as liabilities. Purchase returns should be deducted from the purchases. Sales coming in the trading account. Commission received 53,000 coming in the credit side of the P&L account because it is considered as income. And last, capital. The net worth of that particular sole trader, so it's coming in the liability side. So the solution will be like this. First we have to prepare the trading account in the books of Mr. Kumar, trading and profit and loss account for the year ending 31st December 2019. So debit balance and credit balance we are showing. So usually we'll start with the opening stock. So two opening stock, 2 lakh, two purchases because of adjustment we are writing in the inner column, 7,50,000 less returns. So we have to subtract purchase returns. 7,20,000 will be the net purchases. Next, to carriage inward, 75,000, to wages 3,65,000. Coming to credit side, by sales 10,20,000, by closing stock 2,50,000. So here actually expenses are more. So your incomes is your revenue is less. So you will end with gross loss. So by gross loss carry forwarded. So next we will go to the P&L account. So first we have to take the gross loss. So by gross loss 4,49,000. Here it will be writing in the debit side. Two gross loss brought down 90,000. And there are two expenses: salaries 1,20,000, repairs 12,000, and rent and taxes 2,80,000. There is one income by commission received 53,000. So when you take the net balance, again here also showing deficit balance, means there is a loss. The expenses are more, incomes are less. So it should be transferred to the balance sheet where we have to deduct from the capital. So if there is a profit, we have to add to the capital. So finally, we have to prepare the balance sheet as on 31st December 2019. Liabilities, capital, we have adjustment 33 lakh. Subtract the net loss, I think the outcome of the P&L account 4,49,000, 28,51,000 you will get. Again, subtract the drawings, the amount used for the personal purpose, 26,85,000 will be the net capital. And last item, sundry creditors, 12,000. On the other side, assets, the fixed assets, land, 21,50,000, there is no adjustment. Stock in trade, that is a closing stock, 2,50,000. Bank deposit and cash in hand. Ultimately, the balance sheet should tally. So liabilities, 26,97,000 is equivalent to the asset, 26,97,000. So thank you.